Okay, what I'm going to show you now applies primarily to the DOS NVRs of the latest generation, particularly the 8, the 8iQ version 2, version 3, and so on, as well as the 16-channel IQs and the 36-channel IQs as well. What these devices do is they have PoE internal ports, as well as a network port out to the rest of the network. And what they do internally is they have two LAN addresses. One LAN is for the rest of the network to suit the modem, router, and the rest of the devices. And one is to suit any of the PoE cameras that are connected to the device directly. So what that means is that cameras that are plugged into the PoE switch will have a different IP address range than the ones that are connected into, let's say, an external PoE switch that's plugged into the modem router itself. So in my little setup here at the moment, I have an NVR on my network. I have one camera connected directly to it, and I have that connected into the modem router. I also have a PoE switch with one extra DOS camera connected into that. So in theory, what I should have is an NVR into the router with one IP address. I should have a camera connected to that external PoE switch that's on that same IP address range. And then I'll have one more camera that's connected directly to the NVR and is on a separate IP address range. So if I use my desktop software, the device manager tool, to search for it, get rid of DVRs because I don't care, I'm going to do a quick search and I find two devices. Here's one and here's the other. Now, I know that my second device here is a camera because I was playing with that for a previous video, and the top device is therefore my NVR itself. Fantastic. So its IP address to the rest of the network is 192.168.1.220. Here is my camera at 1.188. My laptop is onto the 192.168.1.2 address. So this is my camera that's connected into the PoE switch that's plugged into the network, not the one that's built into the NVR itself. From here, I can do my restore, I can do my backup, I can do all the other things that I would normally do with that camera, change IP addresses and so on. I can do the same thing with my NVR itself. But what about that second camera? What about the one that's plugged directly into the PoE switch in the back of the NVR itself? Why can't I see that one? Well, that's because the internal PoE switch is not connected directly to the network in any way, shape, or form. It's only connected to the NVR itself. Now, the devices do this in order to restrict the amount of overall load of video traffic on the rest of the network. In a corporate network or somewhere where there's a lot of devices connected to it, you'll often use things like subnets to be able to separate your traffic so that all your phone system sits on one IP subnet. So, computers don't need to connect to the phones, but the phones need to connect to other phones. So they all sit over in one section. Your cameras might sit in another section. If you have a video streaming service internally, like a news network, or, you're at a pub or club and you run all your channels through it that way, that would often be on its own subnet away from normal web traffic or computers talking and spreadsheets and all the other boring things that computers like to do. So we found one camera that's connected to the network, that's this one, and you found the NVR itself. So how do we find and add that second camera? To do that, I'll have to log into the NVR directly and show you from there. Bear with me. Okay, so we're just going to log into the web interface for the NVR itself. So I put its IP address in up the top. It's new for this browser, so I need to allow Flash to do its thing. Beautiful. Now I'm connected to the device itself, and no, I don't want to add the password, not for this anyway. So I go into my configuration for this unit. I'm going to go down to channel parameters. In fact, I'm going to show you network parameters first to show you what I was talking about with the two LAN cards. So I go into my network settings page, and I can see my LAN 1. I've got a manual IP address assigned to 1.220. I've turned off DHCP for this. And there's my gateway address of 1.1. So both of these are in the .1 subnet. If I go across here though, connect to LAN 2, then I can see that I've got a gateway of .2.1, and I've got a different IP address for the NVR in that second LAN address. So any camera that's connected directly to the unit needs to have a .2.18, well, a .2. something address to make it make sense. Now, the benefit of this one for an installer is, in theory, you could plug in the cameras to the NVR at home. Get it all set up, get everything running and perfectly working on this dot two dot whatever address. Go to site, customer says, oh, but my modem's a 10.0.0 dot something subnet. So all you need to do is change your LAN 1 to match the rest of the network and leave LAN 2 alone, and all your cameras will still work. They'll talk, they'll do exactly what they were supposed to do. All right, so if I go now across to my channel parameters and down to LAN search, what we'll see here is a whole heap of these from the, let's just delete all of those. This was from a demo session I was running. If I go into my equipment search and I do my search now. So within the NVR, you can see we've actually popped up with three cameras. Looks like five, but it's actually three. So it's done its search. Stop that one. On the left-hand side, you can see 199, 188, 188, 188, 188. These two that are on S-Link, these two are separate cameras. They've got different device names. And I've got my Hikvision camera up the top. These two ONVIF ones are the ONVIF versions of these two S-Link cameras. So one of these cameras is connected directly to the NVR itself, and the other one is connected to the external PoE switch. So what I need to do is make sure that they're got the right IP addresses, whether they're connected directly to it or connected to something else. So I know that my camera from the device manager, its serial number was 0288 such and such and such and such. So I know that the one that's connected to the rest of my network is this one. It's the .1.188. So this one I can happily assign to address number one. But this camera down the bottom here is sitting into my PoE switch that's in the NVR itself. Do this to here, and I'm going to choose say 201 for the address for this one. If I modify this one, it says operation is successful down the bottom. I search, try to find these devices again. Now my 1.188 is on the rest of the network, and the .2.1 is connected directly to the NVR itself. So I select this as my camera 2. Not going to worry about the Hikvision one for now. Go across to my channel list for these two, save that, and now I have my two cameras, and they should both be running perfectly. This one is running through, as you'll remember, the external PoE switch that's plugged into the rest of the network. And there we are, the outside or the road of our building. Turn that one off. And then if I go over to channel 2, this one's connected directly into the NVR itself via the internal PoE switch. And once that comes up, you see a lovely view of a bit of the wall and a bit of the window. Fantastic. So just to recap, go into my configuration screen, and you can see that for the two cameras we have here, the 192.168.1 address is into the same subnet, the 192.168.1 subnet, as the rest of my network. So my phones, my devices, my laptops, my network modem, everything else like that is a .1 address. And so any camera that's connected to the greater network has that address. The cameras that are directly connected to the PoE switch that is built into the NVR has a .2 address from there. And you can see that when I do it that way, my cameras are happy, my PC is happy, my NVR is happy, and I can view the cameras, record them, and do everything else that I need to do. If I had extra cameras, I'd assign them to the .1 address if they were to the rest of the network, or the .2 address if they were connected to the PoE switch itself. Thank you.